So the Tides Project is kind of our way of bringing the field back to the lab. We wanted to be able to replicate the tidal processes that occur in our field sites, in the lab, and then, you know, perform our experiments within this little mesocosm we've created. My name is Nate Spicer, and I am one of Dr. Kate Tully's PhD students, and I started in January of 2023. We wanted, one, to use open source microcontrollers and any kind of equipment that you can just buy at a Home Depot or Amazon or something, and to create something that can be used for scientific research. And so that was kind of our framework that we would build this under. And we were also gonna try and make it cost effective.
My name is Brian Moyer, and I'm the field and lab technician in the agroecology lab. We wanted to be able to accurately mimic tides. So what that means is it means a gradual rising and falling of the water level within the growth bin. Yeah, so the device starts out from a reservoir, and the reservoir drains into our growth bin, which that's the bin that the tide actually rises and falls. From the growth bin, the water drains into another reservoir bin, and then from the reservoir bin, it gets pumped up into the main reservoir.
In the end, we created this system of valves and flow counters that allowed us to manipulate the water level inside of a tank pretty accurately.
I'm the one who has engineered and developed the software for Tides. So everything came directly from Amazon. A lot of it is actually just small bits of example code spliced together. So the individual parts are mostly off of Amazon.
So ISCO is an acronym that is used for an automated water sampler, and we use them to collect our water samples in the field. And in addition to those water samples, we have attached we call it the flow module, to all of our instruments out there, and that measures water level and water velocity in the tidal channel that we're collecting our water samples from. From April to about December, we have pretty good data on water level and flow in the channel, and we can use our Tides device to basically replicate the water level that we measure in the field. The Tides system can be used in many different applications. So my specific application at first will be studying how the changing water levels affects greenhouse gas emissions from plants and soils within these tidal marshes.
The rough cost of one device is around $250. A lot of that is in like plastic bins. So normally for something scientific equivalent would probably be several thousand dollars. So this allows somebody to make one and play with one with a much better budget, with a much friendlier budget.